Hello and welcome to the Dell Technologies How-To video series. In this video, we will review how to perform an Oracle restore using the NMC recovery wizard. The NMC recovery wizard provides a network or data zone with a centralized recovery method for NMDA Oracle backups, file system backups, and more. Although it is possible to perform various different types of Oracle restores using the NMC wizard, in this video, we will be illustrating how to perform a restore back to the original source location and most current point in time. Before you start, ensure that the Oracle client has performed backups and that these backups are in a browsable state. Although not mandatory, it is recommended that the client was previously created using the NMC wizard. And finally, the Oracle database should be in the appropriate mount mode as per Oracle documentation. Here we can see that we have connected to our database that we wish to restore, and that the database has been placed in the appropriate mount mode before starting our restore operation. Please refer to Oracle documentation for further assistance on this part. Next, you can view the Oracle backups that are available to the network or server by selecting Media, Save Sets, and then filtering on the Oracle client in question. You can filter based on additional criteria such as save time. Here you can see a list of Oracle backup pieces that are available for the restore and their corresponding status, which is browsable. This is necessary for the restore to be successful. To initiate the restore, go to the Protection tab, Client, right-click on the client in question, and select Recover. Next, you'll be prompted with a series of slides to specify the different restore type you wish to perform. Here, we're going to be selecting to recover the database back to the original host and a restore type of Oracle application type. In this slide, we specify the various different Oracle variables necessary to connect to the Oracle database, such as Oracle Home and the credential method we're going to use to connect to our target database. Here, we're going to select Oracle OS authentication. Thus, we specify the OS username and the Oracle SID. We're going to choose to select the entire database for restore. Select Next. Here you can see a list of all the table spaces that are part of the database backup previously done. Since our database is already in the necessary mount mode, we can select No here. Next, this slide allows you to relocate the database files to a different directory other than where they were backed up from. However, we will select the default location to restore the database back to its original location. Here you can have the opportunity to specify the degree of parallelism for the number of restore channels that you wish to allocate. We'll also select to open the database after the recovery is completed. You can also see the different restore type points that you can select. We're going to recover the database to the most current point in time available based on our backups. Additional recovery options are possible, such as diagnostic destination and debug level. Here you can see that the summary of the Armin script that will be generated based on the previously selected choices in the various slides. Here you can see that there's four channels being allocated and the database will be restored, then recovered, and then finally the database will be opened. This slide allows you to specify from a particular media pool should the Oracle backup exist in multiple different pools. For example, if the backup was performed on one backup pool and then it was later cloned, the backup would exist in two different media pools. This slide allows you to specify from which media pool you wish the restore to be taken from. We're going to allow networker to make the decision of the required volumes used for the recovery. Next, you give the recovery a name. And you can choose to start the restore immediately or specify a scheduled time later on. We're going to go ahead and start it off now. Now, based on the size of the database backup previously performed, the restore could take several minutes to several hours based on the size of the database. In our example, the database was only a few gigabytes, so the restore should take a relatively short period of time. Here you can see that there are four channels being allocated for our restore based on the RMN script generated. And the restore begins to read the data from the network or server. You could select finish here, although the restore is still running. And then you can come back to the recover tab up top and view the progress and the status of your currently running restore by double clicking the currently running restore. As you can see here, the restore is still executing. Moving forward a little bit, you can see here now that the restore has completely finished and the recovery has applied all necessary transaction logs and the database was put into open mode as from our previous selection in the wizard. You can also review that by connecting to the Oracle database from the command line. Our database is once again in an open status. Thank you for viewing this video.